So this is the factoring section. So on the factoring sections, all we have to do is factor. Now, anytime you get a binomial with a minus in between, a binomial just means a two-term thing, and we have that minus. This is a difference of squares. And a difference of squares, the nice part is, you can just make all the numbers work out the way you want it to. Like, I need to get 25. How do I get 25? Oh, 5x and 5x. And then you need to get negative 9. Oh, how do you get negative 9? Well, negative 3 and positive 3. And you go, oh, that's going to work out super nice because when I can multiply all these things, they're going to work out nicely. So just make sure when you do the difference of squares and different things that the middle things should cancel out and everything should be the same. This factoring case, we don't have a number in front, so this is just the multiply and add case. When I'm thinking about what multiplies, well, that's going to be x. What multiplies together to give you 10? I'm going to say 5 and 2 is what's going to work. So negative 5 and positive 2. And you can see that that all should work out together. This one, it has a number in front, and you also want to try to divide the number out. When I look at that, the question is, can I divide the number out? And the answer to that is no. No matter what you try, you can't divide this out because 8 isn't divisible by 5 and neither is 4. So this is sometimes when you have a trinomial, it's easier to have a fournomial. And so how you make this into a fournomial is you're going to take the first number and times it by the last number. That's going to give us negative 20. And then after we get our negative 20, what we're going to end up doing is thinking about what multiplies together to give us negative 20 and adds together to give us 8. That's not too bad. That's going to be negative 10, or positive 10, and negative 2. So now we can rewrite that as 5x squared plus 10x minus 2x minus 4. And from here, I know that I have 4 terms, so I can end up cutting this in half. And factoring out the front half, which I can factor out the front half to be 5x, and that's going to leave me with x plus 2. And then I can factor out the back half, which I'll factor out the negative 2, and that's going to leave me with x plus 2. And then, because factoring is always taking out what's the same, what is the same is x plus 2, and then we put what's left over in its own space, which gives us 5x plus 2. Or, whoops, I put plus 2, but that was a negative 2 right there, so that'd be 5x minus 2. Okay, let's look at this one. When I look at this one right here, I go, what would work for this binomial? And most people for this binomial want to say this is 3x plus 6 and 3x minus 6. And if you say that, you're wrong. Because a ne positive 6 and a negative 6 does not give you positive 36. This is one of the tricky cases, because this is a sum of squared. See how this is squared and this is squared? Sums of squareds will not factor. So all we can do is see what will divide these two numbers. And what would divide those two numbers would be a 9, and then I'm stuck with, whoops, this. And that would be my final answer. Okay? Make sure when you're factoring these things that you don't try to solve them. They're not set equal to zero for a reason. And on each problem, just know the different types, right? Like, if it's a difference of squares, know how to do difference of squares. If there's no number in front, know how to factor like normal, like multiply and add. If there is a number in front, remember you need to make that into a fournomial so that you can factor it easier. And then, if it's a sum of squares, it will not factor. It's not going to factor out, so you just do as much as you can. Okay, let's try the next problem. Now this says use the discriminant to decide how many solutions I have. So you can do this one of two ways. We have to use the discriminant, so we're going to use the discriminant to actually find this. But if you really wanted to know how many solutions there are quickly, if you graph this, what solutions are is how many times this thing crosses the x-axis. So if it does that, you have two real solutions. If it does this, you have two imaginary solutions. And if it does this, you have one real solution. So that's what we're really trying to find. If you graph this thing, you can see that on the graph pretty easily. However, they want us to use the discriminant. And the discriminant is the part of the square, the quadratic formula that decides if you're going to have answers or not. Which the only thing in math that can break is dividing by zero or taking the square root of a negative number. And so, in the quadratic formula, since it's negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, this is the part that can break. So we're going to just plug everything in to that part that can break and see what we get. So we're going to get 49 minus negative 3 times negative 5. And when I do that, And when I do that, what we're going to find is this is going to be 49 minus, that's 12, and 12 times 5 is 60. So it's going to be 49 minus 60, which that is going to be the square root of negative 11. And as soon as I see that, I go, oh, look, square root of a negative number, that gives me imaginary solutions. So this would be B. It'd be two imaginary solutions. Okay. Let's try the next problem. Okay. So when I look at this, I need to simplify this. How you simplify this is you just distribute. So we're going to distribute this out to everything. When I distribute this out to everything, I'm going to get 9 minus 12i minus 6i plus 8i squared. Now from here, I'm going to combine my like terms, so 9 minus 18i plus 8i squared. And as soon as I see an I squared, I'm going to know from seeing an I squared that an I squared is an actual number. Because I is the square root of negative 1, so I squared is negative 1. So that's going to flip my sign on my negative 8. So that is going to become 9 minus 18i minus 8, which would give me my final answer as 1 minus 18i. Let's do the next one. This is the same problem, they just put some negatives in there. So because it's the same problem with just some negatives, or some square roots, we're going to evaluate the square roots first. So when I see that square root, I'm going to see the square root of negative 4, and I know that that is 2i. And I'm going to see that this is the square root of 16, so I know that that is 4i. So I can actually rewrite this as 5 minus 2i times 2 plus 4i. And then we just do what we did in the last problem. So that's 10 plus 20i minus 4i minus 8i squared. And we should know from the last problem that an I squared is negative 1, so it's just going to switch this sign. So I'm going to get 18, so that's going to be a positive 8, 10 gives you 18, plus 16i. And that would be my final answer. Let's do the last problem. Okay, so we're going to solve this system of equations. The easiest way to solve this system of equations is if you graph this thing, it should cross in 2 points, and you just find the 2 points where it crosses. So you can do it on a graphic calculator, Desmos, whatever way that works. Now, I think it's actually might be easier to solve it this way, and how they probably want you to solve it is you want to set these you want to use substitution to set these systems equal. So we're going to take this and actually plug it in for the y over here, and use substitution to solve. So that's going to be 9x minus 7 equals x squared plus 3x minus 2. And now that I have this, we're going to get all the numbers to one side. So I'm going to minus 9x minus 9x plus 7x plus 7x. And I'm going to get that 0 equals x squared minus 6x plus 5. Well, that's going to factor really easily into x minus 1 and x minus 5. So my x values for these things are 1 and 5. Well, these are points. So when I look at this point, I know this point's 1 comma something, and this point's 5 comma something. And I need to find the y values. Well, if you have x values, how do you find y values? Just plug it in. So 9 times 1 is 9, minus 7 is 2. 9 times 5 is 45, minus 7 is 38. So those are my points. So my points would be 1, 2, and 5, 38. Okay. This is page number 4, or 3, if you got stuck on anything here. This is the video. Make sure you go back, watch. If you have questions, let me know. And then we'll go on to page 4 for the next video.